Hi! Many of you were asking how to place text behind an object in a video. In this tutorial, we'll show you how it's done in VSDC Video Editor. First of all, there are a couple of ways to achieve this effect. The first and the most correct one is to shoot your video in front of a green background, then apply chroma key and use it for your project. Just import the video to the program, open Video Effects, and apply Background Remover. Make sure you've removed the background correctly and there are no green spots left in the video. Next, add a text object to the scene and place it one layer below on the timeline. This way, it will be placed behind the layer with the video in the scene. And voila! This is how it works. Now let's move on to the next method. If you don't have a chance to shoot a video in front of a green background, you may be able to get away with video masking. For that, however, you'll need to record a one-shot video without moving the camera frame. If the video came out a bit jittery, here's how to fix that. Make a right-click on the video and select Create Movement Map from the menu. Choose a contrasting point on the object, in our case it's a laptop. We'll be using the corner of the screen as a tracking point. When ready, hit Start Analysis. When the analysis is over, hit Apply Editing and go back to the video. Now let's recreate the text layer from the previous example. Make a double click on it and apply the Free Shape tool. Outline the object behind which you want to place the text. Paint that object black and select Mask from the Blending Mode menu. Boom! The text is now behind the laptop! How cool is that? However, there are still some adjustments that need to be made. If you start playing the video, you'll notice that there will be minor imperfections on the sides, because unlike the video, the mask isn't moving. Here is what to do. Go back to the free shape, double-click on it, and add a movement map. Play the video again. Looks great! Now, the only issue with this approach is that we are only able to use one tracking point. Meanwhile, if you are dealing with the object's perspective, you'll need to have at least two tracking points. We're on it! Hopefully, we'll be able to upgrade the motion tracking module in one of the next versions of VSDC. Stay tuned! Method number 3. In this example, the text appears from behind the object. In our case, it's a boat! The idea behind this approach is very similar to the previous one. First, we need to track movements of any selected point on the boat. Next, we add a text layer and create a free shape. However, in this case, you'll need to outline a bigger area, not just the object. It's important because you want to create an overlay of the frame border. Paint the free shape black, select Mask from the Blending Mode menu. And the last step is to add the movement map to the free shape mask. Open the Add Object menu, proceed to Movement, and select Movement Map. We hope at least one of these methods will work for you, and most importantly, you've got the hang of masking and motion tracking. Subscribe to our channel. If you want to see more tutorials like this one, and leave your questions in the comments below.